Hello friends, I am Prashant Vishwanath Dhanshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I am here to explain you about the expression for the crippling load when both ends of the columns are hinged using Euler's column theory. The learning outcomes of today's lecture is the students will be able to study the concept of long column and short column and the assumptions made in Euler's column theory. They will also be able to derive the crippling load of the column with both ends hinged. So, what is compression member or column or a strut? So, these are the member in a structure which are subjected to axial compressive load. So, the column will be the structure which is vertically and with both ends fixed and subjected to axial compressive load, whereas strut will be the member which is not vertical and one or both of its ends are hinged or pin jointed, which is also subjected to axial compressive load. The difference between long column and short column. A column is said to be long when the length upon least lateral dimension is greater than 12. So least lateral dimension means if you take the cross section of the column, so it will be breadth and depth. So whichever is the least in that, that will be taken as least lateral dimension. So whereas short column will be when the length divided by least lateral dimension is less than 12. So generally the long column fails by buckling, so it is subjected to buckling stresses, whereas short column fails by crushing and it is subjected to crushing stress. The radius of gyration in case of long column is lesser than that of short column, whereas load carrying capacity is lesser for the long column and greater for the short column. Now you can see the failure mode in case of long column and short column. So in case of long column, the failure takes place by buckling. So this is the how it buckles. Whereas in short column, the failure takes place by crushing. So here the crushing occurs, and in case of brittle material, a fracture takes place. Sudden fracture will take place. So the assumption made in Euler's column theory is that the column is initially perfectly straight and load applied is axial. The cross section of the column is uniform throughout its length. The column material is perfectly elastic, homogeneous, isotropic, and obeys Hook law, that is, stress is proportional to strain within elastic limit. The length of the column is very large compared to its lateral dimension, so that we have seen that length upon least lateral dimension, it is greater than 12. The direct stress is small compared to the bending stress, and the column will fail by buckling alone. The self weight of column is negligible. Now how the failure of column takes place? So in case of short column, the failure takes place by direct compressive stress. As it is not a long column, it fails by crushing. So the crushing stress or compressive stress is compressive load divided by area. Whereas in long column, the failure takes place by buckling stress. So buckling stress sigma b is equals to p into e by z, where e is the eccentricity of a buckled column and z is I upon y, that is section modulus. Whereas in between the long column and short column, the failure may take place by combined effect of direct compressive and buckling stresses. Sign convention. A moment which tends the column to have a convexity towards its initial center line is taken as positive. And the moment which tends to bend the column having concavity towards the initial center line is taken as negative. Now, what is crippling load? Here, pause the video and try to write answer on a paper. The load at which the column just buckle is known as crippling load, or it is also known as critical just, or it is also known as buckling load. Now, for the expression of crippling load when both ends of the columns are hinged, so we will assume or consider a column AB having a length of L and cross-sectional area A, which is hinged at A and B, and the P is the crippling load which will just buckle the column. And due to this crippling load, the shape of the column will be deflected shape of the column will be AC and B. Now we will consider a section at a distance of X from the end A, and at that point the deflection is Y. So the moment due to the crippling load at this section is P into Y. So minus P into Y. So negative sign, because this concavity is towards the center of the column. So we are giving your negative sign. But the mathematically moment is given by EI d2y by dx square. So equating this both moment, so what we will get? EI d2y by dx square is equals to minus P into y. Therefore, EI d2y by dx square, now taking this term on the left hand side, it will become positive, plus PY is equals to 0. Therefore, dividing this whole term by EI, I will get d2y by dx square plus P upon EI into y is equals to 0. So this equation can also be written as d2y by dx square plus alpha square y is equals to 0. That is equation A, where we are considering alpha is equals to P upon EI. Therefore, alpha square is equals to P upon EI. Therefore, alpha is equals to under root P upon EI. So the solution of this equation A is y is equals to C1 cos alpha x plus C2 sin alpha x. Therefore, y is equals to, now putting the value of alpha, so y is equals to C1 cos into bracket, so x term is as it is, and alpha is under root P upon EI plus C2 sin, and x term is as it is under root P upon EI. We have replaced this alpha with under root P by EI. So this is equation number 1. So now we know the end condition. So at x is equals to 0, so deflection y is 0 at A. So putting this in equation 1, we get, so now y is equals to 0, C1 cos. So now we have put x is equals to 0, means this whole term will become 0, that is cos 0, plus C2 sin, again this term will become 0. So now this is equals to 0 is equals to C1, cos 0 is 1, plus C2 sin 0 is 0. So we are getting C1 is equals to 0, that is equation number 2. Now again we know one more end condition, that is at x is equals to L, at B point the deflection is again 0. So putting that in equation 1, we get 0 is equals to C1 cos. Now instead of x here I have put L, L into under root P by EI plus C2 sin L under root P upon EI. So now as C1 is 0, this term will become 0. So 0 is equals to 0 plus C2 sin L under root P by EI. That is equation number 3. So now from this equation we know that for the left hand side to be 0, either C2 must be 0 or sin L under root PI should be 0. So as C1 is equals to 0, and if we again put C2 is also 0, so from equation 1 we get y is equals to 0. This means that bending will be 0 in this column, so which is not true, because so there is a deflection of the column. So therefore the term, second term, that is sin into bracket L under root PA upon EI should be equal to 0. So now when this term will become 0, if sin 0 it is equals to 0, or for sin phi pi is equals to 0, or sin 2 pi it is 0, or sine 3 pi. So for this value the sine is 0, therefore this term L into under root p upon ei, it should be either 0 or pi or 2 pi or 3 pi. Now taking the least practical value from this, so L under root p upon ei is equals to pi. So now squaring this and solving, we get p is equals to pi square ei upon L square. So this is the crippling load for the column with both ends hinged. So these are my references which I have referred. Thank you very much for watching my video.